What's up, you guys? It's Matt here. So I wanted to talk to you about a specific stock today. American Airlines is something that I invested into right from the start. And most of you that watched my dividends videos, the first dividend video that I created, I talked about investing into American Airlines. Now, there's reasons why I invested in American Airlines, and I get so many questions asking me why. So I'm going to break down everything that I see in American Airlines, the potential growth, dividends, all types of things that I see with American Airlines, and hopefully you can see the value in them as well. So before we get started, make sure you hit the like button and hit that subscribe button for more videos just like this one. And remember that you get your two free stocks with Webull down below and one free stock with Robinhood. So go ahead and check those links out, sign up, invest the money that you need to in order to get the free stocks, and then you can go from there. So for me, American Airlines is something that I knew I was going to get into from the start, right? A bunch of people told me not to because of the pandemic. People aren't traveling. People are restricted from traveling, and I feel as though there's a lot of growth there that other people don't see. So let's go into my Robinhood account and see exactly why I think American Airlines is a great buy and why I own 58 shares of American. So first, let's start with a day. One day, I'm up $0, right? Or up or down $0. They're down in the pre-market by 4 cents. So I really don't have anything to go off of there. But when it comes to a week, the stock is up $1.10 from where they were. So this is definitely a good deal because obviously if they're up, then I'm gaining money from it. If you look at 1 month, they're up $2.48. Now they were down to like $11 or so. So they went up, they went back down. Like it was just a very large movement. When it comes to 1 week, where it comes to 1 month, actually. We look at 3 months, and this would be the total lifetime of me owning the stock. They're up $2.13, which is not bad at all. I'm definitely happy with any positive, right? But the main thing I like to focus on is 1 year and 5 years. If I'm going to be holding it for a long period of time, what is the potential growth of American Airlines? Well, 1 year, you can look at it, and the 52-week high is around $31.67. And where they are now is $13.53. Now, are they at their absolute low? I don't know. This is where I go into 5 years. I have to look into 5 years. So when I go into 5 years, I'm looking for an absolute low. And the only thing that comes to mind are current months. You look at the current months and we're at our absolute low when it comes to the last 5 years. So that's a good sign. Now, will it go lower? There's a possibility that it could go even lower, which means that I would want to invest into there. Now, with all of this, they have the potential to go so high when it comes to value, when it comes to their stock price. And I'm happy with potential, especially if I'm going to hold long-term. I was never a long-term trader, but I know exactly how to trade long-term with a simple strategy of growth. Dividends are different. I'm starting to learn, but that's the main reason, I would say, one of the main reasons why I invested into American Airlines was the potential growth over 5 to 10 years. Now, do I expect them to have, you know, $30 or $40 worth of growth? I don't know. I'm not someone that looks for that much of growth. I'm only looking for $5 or $10 as I'm starting to invest. If it's a total of $5 or $10 and I have 600 or 1,000 or 2,000 shares, however many shares, then I'm fine with that. I'm going to be happy with the amount of gain that I get from American Airlines alone, plus what they could give me on the dividend side. Now, people have said something about dividends for them, which is 3%. They said that they were going to cut their dividends. Well, I'm happy with receiving any dividends that I do receive from them, but if I don't, I know that I have a large amount that I could gain on the growth of the stock. And yes, this is my dividend portfolio, but if they cut their dividends, then I know that I'll be able to put that into someplace else. So maybe I'll take the money that I have in American Airlines here, invest it over into Fidelity, and then use that as more of my long-term trading and not use that stock as a dividend investing stock, because obviously this is going to be my dividend portfolio. But I know I will always have this strategy for American Airlines. So right now I have 58 shares. I'm happy with the amount of shares I have. If they do go down, if they go south a little bit more, I'm going to invest in more shares because I feel as though they are going to have this growth. Are they going to be a Tesla or an Amazon? No, I don't ever see that. I just know that they will have growth in the future. They will have this growth, maybe $5, $10, maybe even $30, maybe even double in value. And I'll be absolutely happy with that. So that's my analysis on American Airlines. Let me know what you think about different airline stocks. I do own another airline stock as well, but I wanted to talk specifically about American Airlines because they get a bad rap, really, and I don't like it, especially since I'm invested in it, and I feel as though they're going to have this growth. Let me know exactly what you think. Let me know if you're going to invest some money in certain places, but that's my video, guys. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you get your stocks, your two free stocks with Webull. Make sure you get your one free stock with Robinhood. You don't want to miss out on those opportunities. Also, hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell so you never miss out when I post another video. But that's my video, guys. I'm going to get out of here. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.